Hey guys, welcome back to my hotel bathroom. So for today's video, I stopped by the Chanel boutique here in San Francisco and I picked up a few items. So I thought we could talk about that today. I went ahead and picked up a few of the new lipsticks, the new Rouge Coco Flash. Now, from what I understand, these are replacing the Rouge Coco Lip Shine. I feel like Chanel does this thing where you find a lip color or a lip texture that you love, and then you go to the counter and they're like, oh, we discontinued that because we felt like it. So I'm gonna talk to you guys about the colors that I picked up today. I'm gonna do some swatches and that's gonna be today's video. So before we get started, please make sure to like and subscribe and hit the notification bell on the side so you can know whenever I post a new video. So I've never actually gone to a real Chanel boutique for makeup. This boutique itself is like a real like Chanel boutique with like the bags, the jewelry, the clothing, I'm assuming on different levels. Because they said that they had three different levels. It was like on the main floor, but they had like the cosmetics, like the perfumes, the skincare, they had like the exclusivities there too. And they had the new collection. And it was really a really nice experience. I mean, it's always a nice experience going to a Chanel counter. But there's something about going to like the actual boutique that feels even more extra. So I always have good customer service when I go to the Chanel counters in Montreal, especially now that I have like some connections and friends like at the counters. But going to like the actual boutique itself was like, it felt like a different level. I don't know, like they offered me water, they're like, you want still or sparkling? And it just felt like extra. And as you can tell, the packaging is different. They have the black bag and this camellia here. I'm not sure what type of fabric this is. It's very soft. But anyway, they went ahead and gave me a couple samples too. So the person that I was speaking to, the person who served me, her name was Cindy, I believe. So if I can find her contact information, I'll put it down in the description box down below. She gave me a couple samples. She gave me a sample of the Paris Venise. This is like one of the perfume exclusivities at the store. I tried it out, but I wasn't like, I don't know, I didn't like fall in love immediately. And I kind of feel like a perfume, like you have to like love it right away. But anyway, she gave me a sample of this. I think these are the new perfumes, like the new exclusivities that came out like last year, I think, maybe this year. And she also gave me a sample of Coco Mademoiselle because that's always a classic. And then this is just the receipt here. I mean, it's so fancy, right? Like, here's your receipt in this little envelope here. And then here are the actual products that I bought. So I picked up three shades. I feel like the packaging, like just like the outside here, is basically the same as the Rouge Coco Flash or Rouge Coco Flash? Wow, Rouge Coco Lip Shine. Yeah, that's what I meant. I feel like the box feels similar and also the shape felt very similar, but let's go ahead and open it up. So up until now, this looks very similar to the Rouge Coco Lip Shine. However, this here is different. I think this is supposed to be so you can see the color of the lipstick itself. Like you don't have to open it to see what the color is. I personally think this is like an amazing touch. I don't know, I'm a sucker for packaging. Whenever Chanel comes out with like a matte lipstick and the packaging is matte, I'm like, I'll buy like multiples. So this is just like extra and beautiful. And quite frankly, this is exactly why I buy Chanel makeup, because I want the extra. I want to see this little extra detailing. So I believe there are 30 shades in the Rouge Coco Flash. I did see ones that I have seen before, like they had Boy. I was kind of worried. I was like, I have Boy at home, but I don't really wear it. But I was wondering, are they gonna like discontinue Boy? It's still there. And there were some other ones that, like there's definitely some shades that look reminiscent of other ones. While I feel like Chanel always discontinues colors and lip formulas, like a certain lipstick, like they'll just like discontinue it and come out with a new one. I feel like they do that a lot, but also whenever they have the new launch or new release, they often have colors that are very reminiscent of past ones. So it's always a good thing. You can kind of find like your favorite in the mix. So I'm gonna go ahead and swatch from lightest to darkest. I got three shades. The first one I'm gonna swatch is called 82 Live or Live. So that is this one here. I really just wanted an everyday nude, you know? Like, as you can see, I'm talking while I'm doing this. I don't have to be very precise. Kind of just, you know, in the car, during a red light, you can just kind of slap it on. And these feel so nice. I don't have like the ingredients list with me, but I do know they have like oils in them to make them more slick and hydrating. And also, I said there are 30 shades. Some of the shades are very opaque and some of them are very sheer. So you kind of have to like swatch them yourself because I don't know, like some of them were like I thought would be really intense and were like very sheer, and some I thought would be very sheer and ended up being very opaque. So it kind of varies. And I feel with all of them, you can build them up. Even the ones that are a bit more sheer, you can just like play around with it a bit more. So there you go. That is number 82, Live or Live. This is this color here. I think this is just like a perfect, like everyday kind of color. You don't have to wear a lip liner. You don't have to do like, I don't know, you can just like do it while you're talking and like, it looks pretty. If it kind of goes overboard, it'll be fine. But yeah, I just wanted something like quick and easy that I don't have to think too much about. I'll give you guys a swatch on the back of my hand. So this is what it looks like here. So I feel like it looks very sheer here, but then on the lips, it looks a little bit more dark. Anyway, this is number 82. And then you guys know my tendencies towards reds, towards like warm tone reds. So I got some deeper, darker colors. I also picked up number 66 Pulse. That is this one here. This screams my name, obviously. I think this gives you a better idea of what the color looks like here. So let's go ahead and show you what it looks like. This one feels intense. Like it feels like the color is more opaque, but the texture is so nice because it feels like a lip balm. This screams my name, this screams Allie. This is definitely my sort of color. I would wear this any season, but obviously in the summer when I'm more tan, it'll be even nicer. Let me just give you a little swatch here. So obviously this looks very opaque and it comes off as very opaque on the lips. This is what I mean, like some of them just like swatch one time and you have like all the color, and some of them you kind of have to build up. So I kind of feel like you have to try them a little bit in store, or like at least see some reviews online and see some swatches, because I feel like you can't really just like judge on the color itself. You kind of have to see how it wears. So yeah, I love this color. So this is 66 Pulse. I'm so glad that they came out with these, or like that they are revamping the Rouge Coco lip shine, because I am so over liquid lipsticks. I mean, I have some, I still wear some, but like, I remember when liquid lipsticks were worn for like a special occasion when you wanted your lipstick to last for like 10 hours, not for like every day. This, it feels so hydrating and nourishing. The texture feels fantastic. So I think it goes without saying that since this texture is more fluid, it feels more oily and hydrating. Obviously it will not be as long wearing as a liquid lipstick, but I personally will take the comfort. Like, I don't mind just like reapplying. Like, I don't know, I'm kind of over liquid lipsticks. Okay, so I have one last color that I picked up. This is number 94, Désir or Desire. This looks very dark in the tube here, but it really is this like really beautiful berry plummy color. So let me go ahead and swatch it for you. And I feel like when you want to have more color, you just have to go over a little bit more just to get the color you want. And this is a swatch here of all three. So as you can see, they're very shiny. They all feel super hydrating. They really just feel like chapstick or like a lip gloss. Well, not quite. Like, they don't feel like gluey or gloopy, but they just feel slick and hydrating. I love it. So again, this is number 94, Désir or Desire. This is this one here. I think this is one of the examples where when you see it in the tube, you think it's going to be very intense, and then when you wear it, it kind of shears out. And I think it also would depend on your natural lip color, because we all have like a different lip color. So some people it's more brown, some people it's more pink. It really just depends on you. So these are the three that I picked up, and you can kind of see the colors through the caps here, which I don't know. Again, I just love this sort of thing. I think it's really cute, and also kind of helps you in the morning when you're like, okay, I need this color. I kind of went with these three because I wanted like three distinct looks. First of all, orangey reds, that is me. This sort of color, I feel like, always makes my teeth look whiter. I don't know if it's like there's like blue in it that just, I don't know, like a raspberry berry lip, I find is very flattering and easy to wear for any day. And then the nude is like, it's like a no-brainer. Just like slap it on and you have a lipstick. So these are the three shades that I went for. I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed the swatches. I know a lot of you guys let me know that you like the swatches because you don't always have access to a counter. So I hope this was helpful for you guys. Let me know down in the comments if you've picked up any shades, which ones are you kind of eyeing. And yeah, I think that's all I have for you guys for today's video. So thank you so much for stopping by. Hope you have a fantastic day, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye.